Hello everybody, I'm Xander. Thank you so much for joining me. Today we're going to look at, it's going to be another video on the new 2020 Grievous Starfighter. You all know it's coming, and I do want to point out one thing before we get started. This, I did a screenshot, I took a screenshot of the Starfighter in the German LEGO catalog. We don't have official pictures of the set right now, but this is the closest thing to that, so I just wanted to say that we are going to be looking at Brick Story Build's YouTube channel. So that is why we're on this, but let's take a look at the ship itself. And we've already kind of dived into it earlier in the month, but I thought we'd continue on, and we'll talk about it in depth here. And this is, again, from a German LEGO catalog, so yeah. And let's talk about it. It is $80. It is going to be retailing for $79.99, which is, I feel like it's a bit steep, and I'll tell you why. The set is apparently only going to be nearly 500 pieces. It's not enough, particularly for a Starfighter like this. It should be a bit bigger. My biggest complaint with this is that LEGO doesn't include the landing pad that Obi-Wan and Grievous were fighting on. But, I mean, that's just my opinion. You guys can put your two cents in down below. Let's talk about this. This ship looks exactly, you know, it looks almost exactly like it did in Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith, which this is an Episode 3 set, so it is going to be Revenge of the Sith, related. And it's going to be based on the scene where Obi-Wan's fighting Grievous near his starfighter, which is cool. They haven't actually done, an updated version of this since 2010. So this is, of course, based on the 2010 model from the Clone Wars, which I do have that. This looks very similar to that. I'd say this one looks a lot closer to the movie version. The 2010 one looked more like the Clone Wars one, which is fine. But this one looks definitely like the movie one. It has a lot more curves. Let's talk about some of the newer pieces here. You've got lots of smooth pieces. These long nose gray pieces are being used here, which is good. You got three of them this time. One of them, of course, on this main fuselage, and you got two on the wing pods here. And one of my biggest issues with this, I have a few gripes with it. They have stud shooters here, right? And on the 2010 General Grievous Starfighter, those were used. They had actual laser cannons, like physical cannons. But I don't know. I think it should have been just an actual physical cannon on each side rather than just stud shooters, because I know it's more playable. But the ship isn't actually the most playable thing in the world. And it shows in the movie as well, and as well as the Clone Wars. But, I mean, that's my only big issue with it. I mean, I don't like they replaced the actual laser cannons with stud shooters, but it's fine. It's not a big, huge deal. But it is something to look for if you're, comparing it against the 2010 version, or if it's a gripe for you, then that's fine. It does have some spring-loaded shooters on the bottom. Something I didn't talk about before is they actually include the orange spring-loaded shooters, which is awesome, because I don't have the orange spring-loaded shooters. I only had the red and green. And if you don't know, LEGO doesn't include the orange spring-loaded shooter bolts that much, really, at all. And same with the blue ones. They don't include those in any of the sets, really, which is very cool. I'll be happy to get some of these the orange ones, orange spring-loaded shooters, which is cool. This has a lot of similarities to the 2010 model, and I'm pretty sure some of the features, you can see one feature here on the side of the wing pod. It's interesting. On the previous version, you kind of flipped down this part. It was like a Technic build, and you flipped it down. Well, in this version, you kind of just slide it open. I don't know how that's going to work, but I'm really interested to see how it's going to work. And apparently, you can put General Grievous' lightsabers in there, which is really, really cool. Because in the 2005 version, you could do that on the bottom. They had little clips on the bottom that you could put the lightsabers on. And that was okay. But the 2010 model didn't have that. It had like a little layer side build where you could put the lightsabers, which was okay. But I think this is the best thing. I think this is so cool that you can put his lightsabers inside the Starfighter, which is super cool. And that's one of the features. And of course, you can slide open the cockpit, I'm assuming, just like the old one. because you can see there's this stopper here, and there's some sliding pieces here. And I believe it's the same cockpit as the 2010 model. I could be wrong on that, but it could be a brand new print. I don't know. I know it's the same piece that they've been using since 2010, so nothing new there. But I believe it's a new printed piece, a new print for it. And I assume that the, you know, spring-loaded shooters can fire, sub-shooters can fire, and I assume that the back tail fin can actually move up and down. I'm pretty sure that's a feature as well. And I'm interested to see if there's any stickers with this, because I don't see any here. I don't see any stickers on the outside, which is really interesting. Because, you know, the last 2010 model had the triangle stickers along the side pods. I don't know if they're going to include that. I assume they're going to include some sort of detail inside the cockpit. And something really cool is that you can actually fit Grievous with all four of his arms inside the Starfighter. That last version couldn't do that. You had to take the arms off, the two arms off of him. But this one, you can include, he's got the four arms. You can just put him in there and you don't have to take anything off, which is great. It looks like it has much more detail than the 2010 model. It has lots more shaping, lots more curved, smooth pieces, like under here. It's got more accurate colors on the striping details in between the wings. Got some newer pieces like these curved pieces here. Got lots of gold details, which is great. That is, of course, accurate to the ship in the movie. And then the Clone Wars. So if you want this to be an Episode 3 set, it can be. If you want it to be in a Clone Wars set, it can be that as well, because it's the same ship. So that's cool. And I'm just still looking forward to this. $80, I prefer it to be $60. Because you're getting about $60 worth of stuff here. You're getting three minifigures, and you're getting a bigger, big-ish build. This does look a little bit smaller than the 2010 model, which is fine. I think it's probably a lot more sleeker, a lot more accurate, a lot more curved and smooth than the 2010 model. That one was a lot bulkier. But let's look on to the minifigures. You get three of them, which normally that would be kind of a low amount, but this one... this set partly is so expensive because you're getting a General Grievous, you're getting an Airborne Clone Trooper, he was the mystery figure we didn't know for a while. You're also getting Obi-Wan Kenobi. I'll get my big issues out of the way first. For Obi-Wan, okay, it's gonna be a bit of a rant. They use the same one for the duel on Mustafar, and I'm pretty sure they're including him. Ugh, that is disappointing, man. That is, that's rough. That's lazy. Just like I said in the last video, that's lazy that they're including the same Obi-Wan from this duel on Mustafar, the $20 set. Of course, I plan on getting that, but this, it's not, Obi-Wan doesn't have the charred robes. He doesn't have any kind of damage on his tunic or robes on the scene when he's fighting Grievous, so that is inaccurate. His faces are inaccurate. I just kind of wish they would include it for his double-sided head. I kind of wish they would include a fighting face. Or, and a smile on one side to, you know, troll Grievous when he says hello there and stuff like that. I don't know. I'll have to see the set in person. I'll have to see if it's worth it, getting that Obi-Wan again. I really think Lego have dropped the ball on Obi-Wan in this set. I really wish they included a new version with new expressions, a fighting face, and a smiling kind of trolling face, you know, happy kind of face, you know, a smirking head. A smirking expression, and a fighting expression for fighting Grievous and trolling him. But that's my complaints about Obi-Wan. I think it's great for me to get another Obi-Wan. It's been a while since I got him in a set, so this is great for me to pick him up regardless. Airborne Clone Trooper, cool figure. Not exactly well, he is accurate to the scene, but I would have preferred a Commander Cody. Phase 2 Commander Cody, personally. But I think this is a good inclusion, especially because I don't have the battle pack it's based on. That's a cool inclusion. General Grievous, one of the big problems I have with him in the set, just a bit, it's a minor nitpick. I wish he was tan. That's literally the only thing. I just kind of wish he was tan. Maybe if he came with a cape, that'd be cool. But, yeah, that's my only complaints with him. I can't wait to get another General Grievous. It's been a while since he came in the set. It's been 2 years. The Combat Speeder was the last one in 2018. So I'm just excited for people to get Grievous in the market again. This is one of the only sets to come with General Grievous. In fact, this is the only set to come with him. In this wave. So I just want to see Grievous come in more sets with Grievous, I'll buy him. So yeah, you get General Grievous, you need him because it's his Starfighter, you get an Airborne Clone Trooper to fight with Obi-Wan, which is really cool. We haven't seen him in a while, and he's very updated, very exclusive. Of course, he's going to be the exclusive character in the set. And Obi-Wan Kenobi, really hope it's not the Duel on Mustafar version, because I prefer that one to be exclusive to that set, but whatever. I'm just excited to pick this set up regardless. I'm definitely buying it. I think I might wait until it hits $60, perhaps 60, 70. I don't know, but I'm definitely planning on getting it. But good figure selection. Good choices here. I just think Grievous should have been tan. Obi-Wan should have been a brand new figure with new faces. And the Airborne Clone Trooper, it should have been the Commander Cody from the start. But I love all the figures. This is 75286, by the way. It's called General Grievous Starfighter. It's going to come with approximately 487 pieces. It's going to be retailing for $80, which is kind of steep. I prefer it to be 60. But I love the set. I think it looks fantastic. I think it is one of the better upgrades, especially from 10 years ago. The last Grievous Starfighter was 10 years ago, and boy, this thing looks so sleek. I mean, they have nailed the design, pretty much. I just wish those weren't stud shooters. That's just my big complaint with this, but you can slide the cockpit forward, you can slide these side pods forward to put lightsabers in there, you can fire the missiles, and it just looks so cool. I assume the tail fin can spin, you can fire all these blasters. It just looks awesome. I just wish it was $60. Those are my thoughts on the General Grievous Starfighter. I think the figure selection is pretty spot on. It's pretty good, although, I have some issues. We already covered that. And I think the Starfighter is a very good upgrade. It's like the Slave One, where it's a very good upgrade, and it's not a collector's edition. It's not overly expensive. It's not, $100, $200, $300. It's just, $80, which is great. And, I think I might buy it at full price. I'm thinking about it. My birthday's coming up. I might buy it at full price. But, the summer sets are being delayed. So, I mean, they're not really summer sets anymore. But I'm gonna do more videos like this. I'm gonna cover four sets: the Boba Fett helmet, Razor Crest, Battle First Legion's Clone Troopers set, and the new AT-AT Walker. So look for videos covering those in the coming week. But thank you so much for watching. This was my analysis of General Grievous Starfighter. This is a very clear image of it, so now we can actually see what it looks like. And it looks good. Looks good. Looks like a great upgrade. This is my second favorite starship from Star Wars, other than the Slave One. But that's my favorite one. But this was my look at it. Sorry for the long video, but we'll see you guys next time. I hope you guys like this. What do you guys think about the new Grievous Starfighter? Do you think it's overpriced? What do you think about it? Do you like the figures? You like the ship? Do you think it's about time we had a new Grievous Starfighter on the market? What do you think? So those are my thoughts. Thank you so much, and hope you have a fantastic rest of your day. Hope you stay safe and healthy. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and we'll do more videos about this, about these new sets, in the next week. So look forward to that. We'll see you guys next time. Thank you so much. This is my look at the new Grievous Starfighter. I'm so hyped for this. So pumped to be buying it, and I'm so happy that it's being on the market. Being released on the market again. So, thank you so much. We'll see you guys. Have a fantastic rest of your day. We'll see you guys. Bye-bye.